Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to discuss the Rankine's earth pressure theory for cohesive soils with surface horizontal from the chapter earth pressure theory. Let us first talk about the active pressure. So suppose this is the retaining wall. This is the soil which is retained by the retaining wall. So, as this is active condition, the retaining wall moves away from the soil. As a result, soil gets stretched and the pressure which is exerted by the soil on the back on the retaining wall decreases. So, at certain point, the soil becomes on the verge of failure. That means failure condition is reached, but failure doesn't occur because of the presence of the retaining wall. So that state is called as active state, and the horizontal stress acting on the retaining wall is called as active pressure PA. So in this diagram, the active pressure is represented as point E. So in case of active pressure, the horizontal stress is minor stress. It is represented as PA, and the vertical stress is major stress because vertical stress is greater than the horizontal stress. As the soil is on the verge of failure, the Mohr circle touches the failure envelope at point D. So here the soil is cohesive. That's why in this case the failure doesn't passes through origin. It intersects the y-axis at point C dash. That means even if the vertical pressure is zero, then soil will exhibit the resistance. And this resistance is due to cohesive force in between the particle. So here this distance is called as cohesion intercept. This failure envelope intersects the x-axis at point F. So distance between the origin and point F is equal to C cot phi dash, where phi dash is the angle of internal friction. Here EC is the radius of the circle. So it will be equal to sigma 1 minus sigma 3 divided by 2. That means half of the diameter. The distance of center C from the origin will be equal to sigma 1 plus sigma 3 divided by 2. So here point B indicates the vertical stress sigma V, which is major principal stress sigma 1, and point E indicates the minor principal stress, which is sigma 3. It is equal to active pressure. There is relationship between PA and sigma V, and it is PA upon sigma V is equal to constant in both active and passive condition. So now we are going to derive the expression to determine the value of K for both active and passive pressure, but now we are considering active case only. So we are going to derive the relationship for active case. So here, if we consider the figure F, C and D, then we will get sine phi dash is equal to CD upon FC. So CD is equal to EC because both are the radius of the same circle, and we can write FC as FO plus OC. So sin phi dash become equal to EC divided by FO plus OC. So we can write sin phi dash equal to EC is the radius of the circle, which is equal to sigma 1 minus sigma 3 divided by 2. And FO, we can write FO as C dash got 5 dash. Plus, we can write OC as sigma 1 plus sigma 3 divided by 2. So, sin 5 dash becomes equal to sigma 1 minus sigma 3 divided by 2 divided by C dash cot 5 dash plus sigma 1 plus sigma 3 by 2. By doing cross multiplication of this equation, we will get sigma 1 minus sigma 3 divided by 2 equal to sigma 1 plus sigma 3 divided by 2 into sin 5 dash plus C dash cos 5 dash as cot 5 dash into sin 5 dash is equal to cos 5 dash. Again, if we further modify this equation by taking terms of sigma 1 and sigma 1 together and sigma 3 and sigma 3 together, we will get sigma 1 divided by 2 into 1 minus sin 5 dash equal to sigma 3 by 2 into 1 plus sin 5 dash plus C dash cos 5 dash. Again, if we divide the equation by 1 plus sin 5 dash, we will get sigma 3 equal to 1 minus sin 5 dash divided by 1 plus sin 5 dash into sigma 1 minus 2c dash cos 5 dash divided by 1 plus sin 5 dash. We will name this equation as equation number A. So, equation A is sigma 3 equal to 1 minus sin 5 dash divided by 1 plus sin 5 dash into sigma 1 minus 2c dash cos 5 dash divided by 1 plus sin 5 dash. As sigma 3 is equal to active pressure PA and sigma 1 is equal to vertical stress sigma V, then this equation A becomes PA is equal to 1 minus sin 5 dash divided by 1 plus sin 5 dash into sigma 1, which is vertical pressure, and that is equal to gamma Z, minus 2C dash cos 5 dash divided by 1 plus sin 5 dash. So, here 1 minus sin 5 dash divided by 1 plus sin 5 dash is equal to tan square 45 degree minus 5 dash by 2. We can write this as Ka, which is coefficient of active earth pressure. And cos 5 dash divided by 1 plus sin 5 dash is equal to tan 45 degree minus 5 dash by 2. But here, tan square 45 minus 5 dash by 2 is Ka. So, tan 45 degree minus 5 dash by 2 will be equal to under root of Ka. So, this equation will become now Pa equal to Ka into gamma z minus 2c dash under root of Ka. So, this is the equation to determine the active earth pressure acting on the retaining wall at depth z. So, at the depth z is equal to 0, this entire term becomes equal to 0. So, active earth pressure Pa is equal to minus 2c dash under root of Ka. So, suppose this is the retaining wall, this is the soil retaining, then at depth z is equal to 0, means at the top of the soil surface, the pressure will be equal to minus 2c dash under root of Ka. So, here the negative sign indicates that the pressure is negative. Negative pressure means the pressure is tensile, because we know that in soil engineering, positive stresses are the compressive stresses and negative stresses are the tensile stresses. And these stresses are undesirable because we know that soil has very low tensile strength. So this stresses tries to cause pull on the wall. This tensile stress decreases with increasing depth. So if we draw a pressure diagram for this retaining wall, then at the top it will be equal to 2c minus 2c dash under root of ka. It will be negative. So as the depth increases, this first term ka gamma z comes into picture and it increases with increase in depth. As a result, this negative pressure gradually decreases and at certain depth it becomes zero. This depth is equal to zc, that is critical depth. After that it becomes positive and then it gradually increases. Then at the base of the retaining wall it becomes equal to ka gamma z minus 2c dash under root of ka. So here it is positive, that is compressive. So at depth zc the pressure is zero. So in order to determine the value of zc, we will have to put the value of active pressure as zero. So 0 equal to ka gamma z minus 2c dash under root of ka. So the value of zc can be equal to 2c dash divided by gamma under root of ka. This depth zc is known as depth of tensile crack, because above this depth the pressure is negative, that means it is tensile, and below depth zc the pressure is positive, that means compressive. Now suppose if you want to find the value of active pressure at any depth, say at depth h, then we can put this value in this equation to determine the value of active pressure. So the pressure at the depth h is given by Pa equal to Ka gamma h minus 2c dash under root of Ka. So we have replaced z by h. So here this figure indicates the pressure distribution diagram for the retaining wall of height h. So here at the top the pressure is 2c dash under root of Ka, which is negative, that means it is tensile. At depth zc it becomes zero, and after that the pressure become positive. So this is positive pressure. At the bottom the total pressure is equal to ka gamma h minus 2c dash under root of ka. So we know the formula for active pressure, Pa equal to ka gamma z minus 2c dash under root of ka. So using this equation we can determine the pressure acting at any depth. But in order to determine the total pressure acting on this retaining wall, then in that case the total pressure will be equal to the area of this pressure distribution diagram. So area of this upper portion is taken as negative and area of this bottom portion is taken as positive. So total pressure will be equal to the integration of this equation from 0 to height. The total pressure distribution against the back of the retaining wall of height h is given by then Pa total is equal to integration of Ka gamma h minus 2c dash under root of Ka from 0 to h into dz. So Pa will be equal to gamma h square divided by 2 minus 2c dash under root of Ka. So this is the expression to determine the total pressure acting at the back of the retaining wall. This equation is applicable before the formation of the crack. Once the crack has occurred, after the occurrence of this tensile crack, the force on the wall is caused only by the pressure from Z equal to ZC to Z equal to H. Means only bottom pressure portion is considered and the tensile stresses are neglected. So, the total active pressure in this case at the back of the retaining wall will be equal to area of this triangular portion only because tensile stresses are neglected. So, the total pressure PA total will be equal to half into height, which is equal to H minus ZC into base, which is Ka gamma H minus 2C dash under root of Ka. So, by substituting the value of ZC from equation ZC equal to 2C upon gamma under root of Ka, we will get Pa equal to half into H minus 2C upon gamma under root of Ka into Ka gamma H minus 2C dash under root of Ka. Then, by further simplifying this equation, we will get Pa equal to half Ka gamma H square minus 2C dash H under root of Ka plus 2C dash square upon gamma. This pressure acts at the height of H minus ZC divided by 3. Means it acts at one third height of this positive triangle. If the soil is submerged under water, then instead of gamma, the value of gamma dash is taken and the corresponding values of phi dash and c dash are taken. Now we will discuss the passive case. Passive earth pressure is acting on the soil. So suppose this is retaining wall, this is backfill. The retaining wall is moving towards the backfill. As a result, backfill gets compressed and the pressure which is acting at the back of the retaining wall gradually increases. And at certain point, the failure occurs. Means soil is at the verge of failure, but failure doesn't occur because of this presence of this retaining wall. So at that point, the pressure at the back of the retaining wall is called as passive pressure. So in case of passive pressure, the value of this passive pressure is greater than the vertical pressure. So passive pressure is taken as major principal stress and vertical pressure is taken as minor principal stress. So here in this Mohr circle diagram, point B indicates the passive pressure which is equal to major principal stress and point E indicates the vertical pressure which is minor stress. So EC is the radius of this circle and it is equal to sigma 1 minus sigma 3 divided by 2. The coordinate of the point C, which is center of this Mohr circle, is sigma 1 plus sigma 3 divided by 2. Here also, since soil is cohesive, the failure envelope doesn't pass through origin. It intersects the y-axis at point C dash. That means y-intercept is C dash. It is called as cohesion intercept. The failure envelope intersects the x-axis at point F. So, distance of point F from origin is C dash cot phi dash. Here, phi dash is the angle of internal friction. Now, from this figure, we have already derived that angle DEC is 45 degree plus 5 dash by 2 in our previous video, and this angle is 90 degree plus 5 dash. As I have said, in this diagram, point E indicates the vertical stress. So here point E indicates the vertical stress, which is sigma 3, and point B represents the passive pressure, which is horizontal stress and major principal stress. So the relationship between PA and sigma V can be obtained as under. So here, if we consider triangle F, D and C, then from this triangle we can see that sine phi dash is equal to CD upon CF. So we can write CD as EC because both are the radius of the same triangle, and we can write CF as FO plus OC. Now we can write EC as sigma 1 minus sigma 3 divided by 2, and FO as C dash cot phi dash, OC as sigma 1 plus sigma 3 divided by 2. So sine phi dash becomes equal to sigma 1 minus sigma 3 divided by 2 divided by C dash cot phi dash plus sigma 1 plus sigma 3 divided by 2. So by simplifying this, we will get sigma 1 minus sigma 3 equal to sigma 1 plus sigma 3 sin phi dash plus 2 C dash cos phi dash into sin phi dash. So we can write this as cos phi dash. Now in this equation, if we put terms of sigma 1 and sigma 1 together and sigma 3 and sigma 3 together, we will get sigma 1 into 1 minus sin phi dash equal to sigma 3 into 1 plus sin phi dash plus 2 c dash cos phi dash. Now if we divide the equation by 1 minus sin phi dash, we will get sigma 1 equal to 1 plus sin phi dash upon 1 minus sin phi dash into sigma 3 plus 2 c dash cos phi dash upon 1 minus sin phi dash. We will write this equation as equation number A. Now here sigma 1 is the passive pressure, so we will write it as PP. Sigma 3 is the vertical pressure, so we will write it as sigma V. We can write 1 plus sin phi dash upon 1 minus sin phi dash as tan square 45 degree minus phi dash by 2. And we can write cos phi dash upon 1 minus sin phi dash as tan 45 degree minus phi dash by 2. So PP becomes equal to sigma V tan square 45 degree minus phi dash by 2 plus 2 C dash tan 45 degree minus phi dash by 2. So here tan square 45 degree minus phi by 2 can be replaced as Kp, where Kp is coefficient of passive pressure. So tan 45 degree minus phi dash by 2 becomes equal to under root of Kp. So Pp become equal to Kp into gamma z plus 2 c dash into under root of Kp. So here Kp is tan square 45 degree minus phi dash by 2, which is equal to 1 plus sin phi dash upon 1 minus sin phi dash. The failure plane makes an angle of 45 degree plus phi dash by 2 with the major principal plane, which is vertical. So here we can see that the failure plane is represented by line DE, and it makes an angle 45 degree plus 5 dash by 2 with the major principal plane. and of 45 degree minus phi dash by 2 with the minor principal plane, which is horizontal. Now let us talk about the pressure distribution diagram for the pressure which is acting on this back of this retaining wall, which is a passive pressure. So we have derived this formula. Pp is equal to Kp gamma z plus 2c dash into under root of Kp. So when depth is 0, means at the top, the pressure becomes equal to 2c dash under root of Kp, because these terms become equal to 0. So this is the positive pressure, means no tensile pressure is developed in this case. Again, when z is equal to h, which is height of this retaining wall, that means at the bottom of this retaining wall, the pressure will be equal to Pp equal to Ka gamma h plus 2c dash under root of Kp. Here, so z is replaced by h. So this is the pressure which is acting at the bottom of this retaining wall. So the pressure, unlike the active case, is positive throughout the depth. The total pressure on this retaining wall of height h is given by the area of this pressure distribution diagram. So this area can be divided into two parts. The first part is the area of this triangular portion, and the second part is the area of this rectangular portion. So the height of this rectangle will be h, breadth will be 2c dash under root of Kp. And for this triangle, total height will be h and base will be equal to Kp gamma z minus 2c dash under root of Kp minus 2c dash under root of Kp. So this will get cancelled. So total breadth for this triangle will be equal to Kp gamma z. So the total area for this pressure diagram will be area of triangular portion, which is half into height h into base Kp gamma z, plus area of rectangular portion, which is breadth, which is 2c dash under root of Kp into height. So Pp is equal to total pressure at the back of this retaining wall is equal to half into h into Kp gamma h plus 2c dash under root of Kp into h. So Pp will be equal to Kp gamma h square by 2 plus 2c dash h under root of Kp. So this is the formula to determine the total passive pressure at the back of the retaining wall. Thank you for watching.